have a Swissie idea. I'm afraid, Sandra, that the style and content of our entertainment today will absolutely pale into insignificance.
Crazy horse.
And some of you may know the crazy horse, but it was potentially a very nice evening for Sandra's mum because it was a bit of nostalgia, World War II nostalgia, and the trouble is that during the performance, the Hitler.
Two rows from the front, there was no orchestra, there was just this stage. Oh well, we thought, okay, there must be an orchestra somewhere. Perhaps it'll all appear, you know, these things do in these clubs, don't they? So being totally out of club land for such anyway. Next thing, the music struck up, it was only a tape, and there was this stage, and on came all these naked ladies. I said, hang on, we want the costumes, this is what we went for, the costumes. They didn't have a stitch on, they just had these boots and these little tiny moustaches. But I can't have moustaches, how the hell did you know what they were? They must have been something new. They came from all night, they were the little Hitler moustaches. I thought, well, we got one of those, each my mum and I, you know, we don't need one of these, we want to see costumes. But anyway, no chance, no costumes, a little bit of leather here, a little bit of leather there, no costumes. So my mum was, you know, we were a bit disappointed. Anyway, then they came around with the champagne, my mother said, do you want to drink the champagne, they'll have spiked it. Why is it going to spike your champagne? You know, I mean, my mother and I, we'd only be wanted for the washing up, we don't want to No, we didn't have a drop of champagne, it cost me £80 each for this night out, and all we had were bare ladies here with moustaches. Oh, yeah. We did have a little bit of something. Spinning machine and went like this at the top of the machine and came down looking tidy. I mean, you know,
tidy.
But she was a bit saucy at the top there, but around she came and it was saucy but not rude. But we were a little bit taken aback. So then my mum said, look, let's leave it because we can't very well, you know. What about all these people, you know, we were going to taxi. What are we going to do? So we scuttled on the
Tell you like the address of the crazy horse in Paris.
Right. Yeah. The address of the crazy horse. Yeah. Yeah. I think that's so good. And Dave, of course, as well as part. Where was I?
Yeah, follow that, you bastard.
Yeah, follow that. Dave's musical talents. Now, Dave's musical talents. There we now. The front man for so many years of arguably, very arguably, the finest band in
Muscat!
Tour of Mice.
Good!
Now, the band has gone through a lot of metamorphoses over the years. That's a big word. They were Blitz for some time.
Certainly were.
We even played, didn't we?
And the original member again is, of course, Chiro. Then, of course, they evolved into the Hammerheads, who've had a number of lineups, all of them excellent. And Debbie's here. Debbie actually sang. So, the one constant factor, of course, is the legend there.
Hey.
Muscat's answer to Mick Jagger himself.
Excuse me!
God! But things didn't always go to plan. Chiro reminded me of the time.
Oh no!
It was a British Airways do at the Intercom. And during a rendition of one of Dave's standards, Brown Eyed Girl, Dave's Jagger-esque prantings. Even though it was Van Morrison, led to a very slow but potentially disastrous tangling of the microphone lead around his nether regions. Do you remember that?
Yes.
Well, I was going to do an act of that now, but I'm a bit stiff, so.
That should work even better then, shouldn't it, Chris?
I might injure myself.
I'm a bit stiff.
But true from his years, the show had to go on, and he felt arse over tip, the face over apex. And he completed the song. He completed the song whilst he was horizontal and trussed up like a pig at the annual Muscat hog roast. He was there. Well done.
A toast! Absolutely, Mike.
Dave the singer.
Yes!
Dave
the truster.
My God, I'm getting bloody up to him.
Now, the last part of Dave's leisure portfolio is, of course, his sport. Now, Dave is a footballer.
Steady on, Simon.
But I'm struggling to say much about that. I can't say much about that. But seriously, a number of us here can be honoured to say that they've actually graced the same playing field as this legendary person. In fact, instead he started slowing down with the inevitable onset of adolescence.
Sinescence.
It wouldn't have been untrue to compare Dave's silky skills with the likes of the great Pelé, Cortez, and Maradona.
He is pissed.
It wouldn't have been untrue, just a downright lie. No, Gary, you're marrying a very fit guy here. He's still running around like a spring chicken at the ripe old age of whatever he is.
12.
Dave's a founder member of our Monday night five-a-side football and social club. As are Chris over there, Simon, myself, and poor old Clive, who's stuck in London. We are founder members of the Monday nights. And so we need to have a toast. A toast!
Toast! Monday nights!
A toast, ladies and gentlemen, for Monday nights!
Monday
nights!
Absolutely! Monday nights!
Or Pele.
And Pele! Cheers, and guys! In that order!
Jagger,
Pele, and. What an amazing man!
I forgot when I was turning over the pages just now and. I forgot to mention Gail's friends at the British School. They're over here, by the way.
They're everywhere.
They're everywhere.
And over there. And I've got a little note here from a guy called, he's called John Scarf. He said, is it okay if you go back after this and finish your report? Anyway, Gay and Dave, the marriage license you both signed a couple of hours ago, this is serious now. It's a contract. And it's a binding one. True romance. And as in any contract, there are the detailed conditions, the small print, which I know you both read in deep before you signed.
Absolutely, you read it all, yes.
Yeah, read it all. And sometimes in the small print, there's something you might miss. And Gail, you willingly gave your approval to this. Well done, Gail. If Fiona had done this, I'd have been absolutely, really so pleased.
Well, she didn't.
No, but Gail, you have. This is a portfolio of Dave's week. Saturday night, Premiership football. This week, Dave, we're all coming round for the boat race.
No, that was last week.
But we're coming round for the cup semi-final, if that's okay.
Of course.
Yeah. You signed for that. Sunday night is band practice. Monday night is the Monday night, the fireside football. Tuesday night, tennis, World Guard. Wednesday night, football, World Flight. Thursday night, well, Gail, he's actually free on Thursday night. But unless he's playing in the band. If he's playing in the band, he's not free. Friday, Gail, that's chill-out day. It's chill-out day, which means, Gail, don't bother him too much because he's had such a busy week. After all, Dave and Gail, marriage is about give and take. Seriously, Gail said the other night, I don't know whether you remember, that you said, every day is like a honeymoon. Isn't that nice? And I'll say to you both in all seriousness now that marriage isn't a rehearsal. I should know, I've done it three times.
This is the real thing.
Because it's a good job it's not a rehearsal, because if it was, Dave would have been late or not turned up at all. Well, Dave and Gail, you're a smashing couple. And, we all wish you both a very long, happy, fulfilling married life. And the most important toast of the afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, a toast to Gail and Dave.
Cheers.
Hey guys, can I just have one more word? Because
no.
This is important. Pamela pointed out to me that I was taking my duties very, very specifically and very seriously, toasting the bridesmaids. I never really said enough about my wife. Yeah. I want it on record. This lady has made me the happiest man in the world. She's a beautiful person. You guys know that already anyway. I've been privileged to realise that in the last year. And I really consider myself the luckiest man in the world to be married to her today. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Gail, please.
Forget the sun in his jealous sky.
promises like and there have been some that I've broken. I swear in the midst you left, you walk in fields of gold. You walk in fields of gold. Summer days among the fields of barley, see the children run as the sun goes down.
Okay,
now we'll be back.
Among
the
fields of barley,
you remember me when the west wind moves upon the fields of barley. You can tell the sun in his jealous sky. And we walked in fields of gold. And we walked in fields of gold.
Dinosaur remains, millions of years old, but we have found a living relic. Here he is.
Can you speak?
Thomas the Tank Engine.
Speak to us, Trevor.
My best man.
I don't have to speak, this guy's saying it all.
my best man, we've had a fantastic day, and Trevor has played a major contribution. And I want to thank him. I want to thank him.
That's very easy for you to say.
I want to thank him for all the work he's put in. It's been a fantastic day.
Brilliant.